marvelous cricket universe that is the IPL has given us an absolute marvel of a league stage season. And we're now down, pun no pun intended, to the end game of IPL 2019. It's been an incredible league campaign, one of the tightest ever. And we promised you that for the final week of this big season, we'll have something special. And that something special is to my right, Rajat Bhatia, IPL champion in 2012, a regular fixture in several knockouts and playoffs with several different teams. Rajat, welcome to Sportskeeda. This is IPL Dishout on Sportskeeda. Thank you for being here.
Yeah, my pleasure. Yeah.
Just touched upon what a fascinating group stage campaign we saw. You had three teams finishing level on points at the top. You had the fourth and the eighth team separated by only 1 point.
Yeah.
You've seen anything like that before in the IPL?
Well, yes, I mean, but if you normally see this IPL, definitely it is far different than the previous IPL. To be honest, you know, my feeling is like, you know, this year we might see a new champion. So you can easily make out, like, I feel Delhi Capital is going to be the one.
Let's just pull up that points table to show you how things finally ended.
If you ask me about the teams which have qualified, I think the first three teams which have qualified, definitely they deserve to be there. I still think like KKR would have been in the fourth, but then one man only, Russell, and then you have to be on his shoulders all the time. I don't think that's one of the things which anybody would like. But yes, still Sunrisers, they are in a happy stage now.
What that's done is that it's set us up to qualifier one, and it is the two arch rivals. It is the classico of the IPL, Mumbai Indians against Chennai Super Kings. How often they've met at the biggest stage. Three IPL finals already played between these two teams. And Rajat, the trends usually tell us that 6 out of 8 times since the playoff concept was introduced, the two teams that finished in the top two have had a rematch in the final.
Because you know what happened, like these two teams have dominated the whole IPL. So it's not only this season, the previous season. The three wins is actually the, you know, Chennai Super Kings, 3 times they won IPL, Mumbai Indians, 3 times they won. So I feel that they know that they are the king. They are the king of IPL. And yes, there is always a thing which is like, you know, you have one more chance if you lose. But back of your mind, you know, you can always know, you can always bounce back. I feel that Chennai, because they are playing in Chennai, and Mumbai Indians have to go back and then have to win one more game and come back again, and then you never know.
All right, so we've got an early prediction. We will get more detailed predictions from Rajat a little down the line. He set it up, Mumbai Indians, Chennai Super Kings, the two kings of this competition. Let's just take a look at how Mumbai made it through to the playoffs yet again after having missed out last season.
Three-time IPL winners, Mumbai Indians, lived up to everyone's expectations and finished the IPL 2019 league stage at the top of the points table. With 9 wins in 14 matches, the MI Pulton looked almost invincible in the first round of the 12th edition. Mumbai started their campaign with a defeat, but they gradually picked up the pace. They have won doubles against Chennai Super Kings and Royal Challengers Bangalore. Surprisingly, they haven't won a single encounter against Rajasthan Royals. The team has been in the mixed form, but their big hitter and a fast bowling all-rounder, Hardik Pandya, ticked all the boxes in this season as he was an all-time savior for MI. He played crucial cameos and even smashed big when required. The bowling department performed to the point for them. Jasprit Bumrah, Lasith Malinga, Rahul Chahar and even Alzari Joseph took big wickets at the right time. Quinton de Kock is the highest run scorer for them till now, and Jasprit Bumrah has taken the most wickets for Mumbai Indians in league games. After attaining the topmost position, Rohit Sharma's men will now have 2 chances of making it to the grand finale in IPL 2019.
Mumbai Indians, number one yet again after a league stage in an IPL season. An odd statistical quirk, Rajat, only twice in 11-12 past years of the IPL has a team that actually finished first in the league stage gone on to win the title. But you think with Mumbai, you see that overall balance, which has been true for them for the last 5-7 years where they won these three titles. You think they are the favorites to go the distance this time as well?
Well, yes. See, they know there's always a set formula for every team. I feel Chennai, they have their own formula, and Mumbai, they know that what's their plan. And that's the best part about IPL. You know, the teams which are playing right now and they are on the top, they know that they have to, you know, tell the individual players that what kind of homework you should be doing and what kind of role you have to be, you are playing. So I feel the major difference what I've seen this year in Mumbai Indians is like Hardik Pandya's performance. And that is one of the reasons why, you know, it has made a huge difference, because when you are good with the ball, when you are good with the bat, and when you are taking the team out from nowhere situation, and that's what it happens whenever Mumbai Indians play.
Hardik Pandya, the key man for Mumbai Indians. We will come back to him. You can't talk enough about Hardik Pandya when you're discussing about the Mumbai Indians. But Chennai Super Kings, who are getting to play a playoff game in Chennai at the Chafok, where they just don't lose, right? Here's a look at how the Super Kings made the playoffs for the 10th time in 10 seasons in the IPL.
Defending champions Chennai Super Kings were fluent throughout the tournament. CSK have played 14 matches in their league stage and they have won 9 out of them. Chennai Super Kings started their 2019 season on a high note by winning first 3 league matches. They have won doubles against Delhi Capitals, Rajasthan Royals and Kolkata Knight Riders, while they haven't won a single encounter against Mumbai Indians in league stage. Surprisingly, Dhoni missed 2 matches for Chennai this season and they have lost both the matches in his absence. CSK's bowlers had done a commendable job for Chennai till now. Imran Tahir, Harbhajan Singh, Ravindra Jadeja and Deepak Chahar, all of them showed their class and turned the tables for Chennai at crucial moments. Imran Tahir is the highest wicket taker till now with 21 scalps, while their batsmen have been in the mixed form. CSK's greats Suresh Raina, MS Dhoni, Shane Watson and Faf du Plessis clicked at the right time and did save some of the matches for them. MS Dhoni has scored the highest runs for Chennai in league matches. Chennai Super Kings was the first team to qualify for playoffs this season, and they can even enjoy the home advantage while playing in the first qualifier against Mumbai Indians in IPL 2019.
The kings of consistency. You say there's only one constant in the IPL, that is the Chennai Super Kings. A lot of commentators tend to say that this is the tournament where 7 or 8 teams play to decide who takes on Chennai in the final. How do you look at their season? It hasn't been, they've been solid at home. They don't lose a lot of matches at Cape Town. But what do you make of their 14 games so far?
See, that's the best part about Chennai Super Kings, that you hardly see any changes in the side. That's the one of the reason, that's the formula. See, what happens when you're playing under Dhoni's captaincy, you know that you're going to get a lot of games. He's not going to make you sit out. Definitely, you know, if you are not performing well consistently, then only. And that's one of the reasons why Chennai Super Kings always, they are, you know, they are on top. And I feel that this year, what's the major difference is, see, there is not that big kind of contribution from each and individual player, but the combination, you know, the contribution of all the players in each and every game is really high, I would say.
Kedar Jadhav is expected to miss the rest of the tournament after that shoulder injury, and Ambati Raidu hasn't scored a lot of runs. Is that the one biggest concern for them, the lack of runs in the middle order? You had Dhoni, of course, come and save the day, but can you expect that to happen every single time?
See, Kedar Jadhav injury is very, I would say that's very unfortunate part. But every year, if a guy is getting injured, that is something which he has to look upon. And Ambati is not getting runs, that's for sure, but he's a big match player. And you have not scored runs throughout the season, but if you get runs in the last few games, it makes a huge difference. Then, you know, people will not remember what you have done. And Dhoni's, I would say that he should be batting up the order now, because somebody has to take the responsibility, and why not captain?
Yeah, and you're just hoping Ambati Raidu puts on those 3D glasses that he spoke about and puts on a bit of a show. But let's dive into the matchups now. And one very interesting number that comes right at the top, which is where Mumbai Indians fans tend to hold their own over Chennai Super Kings, who are the kings of this competition. There is only one team in the history of the IPL who has won more matches against CSK than they have lost. And that is Mumbai Indians. And the funnier number, Rajat, comes in the bottom of our screen. In Chepauk, 5-2 to Mumbai. And the last time Chennai Super Kings beat Mumbai Indians at Chepauk was 2010.
Well, see, I feel that every year there's a new thing which you normally get to see. And 2010 is like something like a long time back. Now the teams are much more smarter. You have computer analysts, you know, they are doing their homework, and definitely, you know, they know what's the plan is going to be when you are playing against Mumbai Indians this time. And if you play consistently against any team again and again, you know that what kind of players they have, what kind of strength they have. And that's what Chennai Super King is all about. You know, they know that what kind of wicket we should be giving. I mean, I'm very sure, you know, this match they don't have that kind of hold on that kind of wicket, but they know how to react on those situations.
Any ideas about what that different factor could be from either camp?
See, I feel that it's all about the team combination. You know, what kind of team you're going to bring out. Like Kedar Jadhav is missing out the next few games. Definitely, there will be some guy who will be sitting out. And to fill that slot, you need a guy like Kedar Jadhav. A guy who can come in and he can hit the way he wants. Or you need a performance from MS or the guys who will be playing down the order, Ravindra Jadeja. I think that's what these few guys have to take responsibility. And if you are playing for the country, and definitely, you know, Ravindra Jadeja is one of the guys who people expect him to perform with a bat. With the bowling, he's all right. But when it comes with batting, you know, he's still lacking behind. He's not up to his potential. So I feel something has to come out. So I still feel, you know, even Mumbai Indians have to bring out some kind of spinner. Like Rahul Chahar is bowling very good. And he's one of the great find right now in IPL. But on those kind of track, you need another spinner to back up. And Harbhajan played for Mumbai Indians for so long. He knows what kind of weakness they have. So let's see. Still, there are a lot of surprises to come out, I would say.
Let's just take a look at the comparison of the way these two teams played through the league stage. If you look at the batting numbers, Rajat, Mumbai obviously score much faster than Chennai. Part of that is down to the fact that Chennai played half their matches at Chepauk, which was low scoring. But as a batting unit, you see that difference in the average score. Mumbai on an average score 170, Chennai 10 to score 145. Would you not read too much into it, given the conditions they've had to play in?
The match where they are playing right now is in Chennai only. So I think that track is going to suit Chennai more than Mumbai. And the other thing what I feel is, yeah, more 7 games if you are dominating, and definitely you know that this wicket and this ground is going to help us whenever we're going to play a big game. And the big game is coming up right now. So I always feel that, you know, where you are playing, that is more important.
And when we look at the next slide, which is the bowling comparison, you'll see where Chennai could potentially have that greater stranglehold that Rajat is speaking about. Because through this tournament, they've conceded 7.3 runs and over. They're by far the toughest team to score against. And when it comes to matches in Chennai, they become even tougher. But what Mumbai have, Rajat, is they have 5 different bowlers who've already taken 10 or more wickets in the tournament. Rohit Sharma likes packing his team in such a way where he has that additional 6th or 7th bowler to fall back upon. That can be so crucial in these crunch games, right? Just having that extra fallback option.
See, to beat a best team, you have to be at your best. I feel that Mumbai Indians are, you know, still capable of performing much better. And playing against Chennai, I think one of the things what I feel is Mumbai Indians, they have a good batting side, but on a wicket like that, definitely they can struggle. And at the same time, they don't have any other spinner than Rahul Chahar.
You mentioned a few players through this conversation. You mentioned Hardik Pandya right at the top, word on Jadeja and Dhoni. I have to ask you to pick one single player who holds greater key than anyone else for both teams. One for Mumbai, one for Chennai. Who are the key players?
See, the key players definitely for Mumbai Indians, it's Hardik Pandya. And if it comes with Chennai, I feel right now this game are Ravindra Jadeja. Because he has to perform with the bat. If he's going to deliver with a bat, definitely it can be a game changer.
There's been one interesting topic which has really been a conversation, a huge debate throughout the season. It's to do with umpiring, and I'm going to ask Rajat about his past with umpires and what he feels about it. But first, let's listen to what the public feels about this topic.
I mean, we should have ICC best umpires for IPL. It's an ICC tournament, right? And there are no other tournaments going on at this moment, if you know. But this World Cup coming, so there is no team which is playing right now, apart from India also. So I think we should have had the best umpires.
I think DRS, bringing the DRS is, I didn't think that it solved the problem. Because previously, umpires used to be careful, right, while giving decisions, right? But you'd see the IPL example. There's so many errors from the umpires. Like, I have seen so many glaring errors, which even the club cricket umpire will not do. So I think bringing this DRS is actually aggravating the situation, right? It's not helping the cause. It's only like depleting it. So I don't think it's solved any purpose.
You know, umpire initially raised his hand and then he changed his mind. And obviously on replays it was shown that, you know, it is a no ball. And he has every right to be disappointed. Even Virat Kohli faced the same situation, you know, if you remember. Last, in a game, you know, where Malinga was bowling, he bowled a no ball and it wasn't even called. But I think the umpire standards in general in IPL is a little low.
Right then, lots of divided opinions. Rajat, this is a topic that tends to divide opinion, be it among cricketers or among those watching from home. Is it fair to say that the umpiring issues have been a lot more this season, or is it just that we are in an age where everything gets highlighted a lot more?
See, I feel now the technology is there. Definitely, you know, people feel that every decision should be given to technology. I feel that they need to improve at domestic level, then only you should get a game in IPL. Most of the captains, most of the franchisees, they are much more comfortable with the foreign umpires. But as we know, even those umpires have made mistake in this IPL. So I think we should not think about, we should not talk too much about umpiring, because that's one of the things which is not under our control. We can improve, but only after the IPL is over.
Mumbai versus Chennai, which of these teams do you see going through to the final program?
I think Chennai, that's the team which dominated throughout the, you know, the IPL history. So I feel Chennai should be going in the finals. And that's what it looks like, as because they are playing in Chennai. That's one of the main reasons.
Yes, Fortress Chepauk, the ground where Chennai Super Kings just don't lose, but the ground where Mumbai Indians haven't lost since 2010. So Rajat is standing with Chennai. Who are you standing with? Who do you think will make the final? And as a result, which team do you think will go into that second qualifier on Friday, which will be in Vizag? Let us know in the comments section. Tell us your thoughts, your predictions, your comments. And we're into the playoffs week, so it is a lot of excitement. Rajat, thank you so much. The first of four big games that we'll be looking ahead to with you. Thank you for your time.
Cheers. Thank you.